Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we will finish off our REST APIs for the customer entity for the MongoDB. So what we will do is we will just try to go one by one. We have get customers, HTTP get. Here we are doing get customer by ID. So we are passing customer ID as a query parameter. Then we have a delete and update. Here you can pass customer ID as a query parameter or as a request parameter. That depends on you. If you want like query parameter, then you have to use query here instead of parent. Okay, query we just need to import. So we are getting customer ID in the query parameter. Okay, and customer ID is of type string. So this customer ID we are passing in the get customer method, and then HTTP status okay, and we are returning the customer which we just got. So this is got. This is HTTP get put post delete. So we also need to have one method to create a new customer. So this method can be create customer, and in the create customer we will be passing something in the body, right? So annotation body. Here in the annotation body we'll have request, and this request will belongs to some DTO. So here you will be passing some data, right? You will be passing request payload. So here we will be using the concept of DTO which we just talked about. Like we can create a DTO, and in the DTO we can create index dot like customer DTO. So DTO contains this thing, like we are exporting customer DTO, and these all are of type string and date, right? This is what we are expecting. If you wanted to make few things required, then you can make these things required in the DTO. So request validation, request payload validation can happen based on this. Like if you want, like is email. So this should be is email, and is defined means it will not be empty. So few things we can make required in our payload, like email. That should be fine, I think. And now we will be using this DTO in our request validation, request payload. So customer param, customer DTO we have, we just imported. Now this customer param as a DTO we can pass to our create method, create customer, and we are just passing it. We will define this method. Okay, it's already available. We'll just update it. Now we have a get customer by ID. We are getting it from the request params. Then we have delete and update. So we can actually use the same thing, query parameter, in both the cases. Here we do have request. I think we don't need it. And this params also, because we are actually, for our knowledge perspective, I have changed it from params to query, so we can just learn something else. Customer ID, I'm passing the ID again. So update customer, request and body. So we also need request here. I will just add the request also, because it's update request, and you will be getting something to update in the request payload. Okay, simple, and request.body we are sending, update customer, and whatever the data we are returning, we are sending it back. Okay, this is our simple controller we have created here. Instead of customize it, instead of putting simple data, you can customize this response. It's a JSON, like you can set message, and then you can set data, right? In the message you can say, customer deleted, something like this. Okay, same you can adopt on other places also. Now let's go to our services, because it's more important. List customer is fine. What we are doing is customer model dot find, right? It's like plain and simple find operation on the MongoDB database. Then we have a get customer. Get customer we are using find by ID. Okay, create customer, similarly we need to update this thing. Yeah, let's remove this for now. We have get customer. So get customer is simple as customer model dot find by ID. We are passing ID here. So this is fine. Now we have update customer and delete customer. Remove customer is simple. In the remove customer, what we will do is customer model dot find by ID and remove. Customer model dot find by ID and remove. Let me check the spelling if we have written correctly. So this is find by ID and remove, find by ID and update. Another thing, another important thing is update customer, right? So here we are getting the payload and the request. So we are getting ID and then customer DTO, like the payload which we are getting of type customer DTO. Customer DTO. Right, and customer DTO we are passing this. So it's like based on the ID. You find by ID and update takes the ID and the new payload which you wanted to update, right? And we are returning the new customer, new updated customer. And if we talk about the create customer is same as we do in the MongoDB. In the create customer, what we will do is we'll create a new object, const new customer equals to await this dot customer model. Customer model, and we just pass the payload which we got. Customer, this is actually the type of customer DTO. We'll just pass the customer, and this customer we are creating, and we are just returning. We will just say new customer dot save. Don't need to use await here. New customer dot save. First of all, we are creating new customer object by passing the payload in the customer model, and then we are saving it. So we are returning that. Okay. So these are like we have created a REST APIs for a customer schema model. Here we are doing find by ID and remove, find by ID and update, right? And save methods. These are the main methods we have used. Okay. So same kind of REST APIs you can create for any other entity which you are aware, and you can just do the practice for this. I will post the source code so you can also take a look. Thanks everyone.